guys, welcome back to my channel, That Look You Love. It's me, Dhriti. In today's video, after so long, I'm getting back the TLYL series. If you don't know what that is, this is a series in which you guys tag me in a look that you love on Instagram and I try to recreate it here on my YouTube channel. So it's a really fun interactive series and you guys get to learn the easy way to do any look that you have seen on Instagram. It can be a celebrity's look, it can be just a makeup look that you really adore and you want to know how they did it. You simply have to be following me on Instagram and also don't forget to tag me with the hashtag TLYL series. And so this is the makeup look right here that I was tagged in by. It's a cut crease and I have semi hooded eyes. So for all of you guys who are even looking to do like a cut crease on hooded eyes, something like that, I share tips and tricks on that as well. Make sure to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell button so you don't miss any of my videos. And now without any further ado, let's get into this video.
So because there's glitter work going on the eyes, I'm going to start off with my concealer and in fact start off with my eyes. I'm using the Maybelline HD Wind and I'm just going to create a base with this for my eyes. Just so that all the eyeshadows easily blend, you want to set the base with some setting powder. It can be loose powder or a compact powder. Now to go as close as I can to the shades she's used, I'm using the red eyeshadow from the Huda Beauty Electrics mini palette and I'm just using a fluffy brush to blend it all really well. This is going to be our first layer. So this is going to be the most buffed out one. Keep blending it well. After that, I'm using a more tapered brush. I'm using the shade Saffron from the Huda Beauty Desert Dusk palette. And I'm going to be using three palettes for this eye look just to come as close as I can to her eye look. Go a little closer to my lid and put this in the outer and inner corner. Also in my crease slightly and buff it out, not as much as the before one. But yeah, you got to buff it out still. I also went in with some brown on top of this. Putting that again in the inner corner and the outer corner. As we keep going in darker with the shades, you want to buff it out lesser and lesser so that you know you get that gradient. Next, I'm going to create a cut crease with my concealer and a flat brush. This is going to be in the center of my lid. You want to take your time in doing this, and if you have hooded eyes, I have semi hooded eyes, you want to go slightly above your crease, your natural crease, just so that the eyeshadows show slightly. I went in with Angelic from the same palette. I thought it was a more pink silver undertone, but turns out it has that warm undertone, which is not the look that I was tagged in. And so I went in with another shade from the Makeup Revolution palette, pinkish white shimmer on top of that. And after that, I'm adding some more of the dark shade from the Makeup Revolution's Fortune Favours the Brave palette just to create that depth in my inner and outer corner. I'm using a nice white shimmer, it's a silver shimmer for my eyebrows, and this depends on what your color is of your outfit. So if you're wearing more silver jewelry, go for this, or you can switch it up with gold, even that looks great. I'm creating a cut crease right over here with a silver pencil, and this is by Maybelline, and on top of that I'm going to go in with some NYX silver glitter. The trick with hooded eyes is to go just slightly above your natural crease so it shows. That's the only thing that's going to make it show. Otherwise, it just gets hidden. You know what I mean? Just brushing away all of it, and I also added some black eyeshadow in the outer corner just to intensify it so it's closer to the look. I felt like that was the only thing missing. So yes, this is as close as I could get. And with that, let's move on to the rest of my face. When there's loose glitter involved, fallouts are bound to happen. That's exactly why I started with my eyes. And I'm just taking a wet wipe and wiping all the glitter from my face. We don't want that. So I'm using the Gulnare Elixir as my base. This is going to act like a moisturizer and also going to hydrate my skin for the winters. This is very needed. Also, I'm going in with a matte foundation, which is the Maybelline Fit Me foundation, and hence you need some good moisturizing under it. I'm using the shade 220. After that's all blended, I'm going to go in with my concealer once again, and I'm going to put that in my under eye area and my T-zone just to highlight all these areas. I'm going to be setting all that in place using the Maybelline Super Stay Compact Powder in the shade 25. And with a fluffy brush, I'm just going to be setting, starting with my under eyes because you don't want that to crease. If you don't have oily skin, you can even skip the powder. The next thing I'm gonna do is go in with the same dark eyeshadow. You can go in with any of the dark eyeshadows that I have used and just put that in the lower lash line. Using the CoverGirl Intensify Me Eyebrow Pen, I'm going to be filling in my brows. This is really intense, so I'm not a huge fan of it, but it will do for now. I just feel powders or gels work way better for eyebrows. But just gonna brush it all out and blend it as much as possible into my eyebrows if it became too dark. Next, I'm going in with the Deck of Scarlet eyeliner, and this is such a beautiful one. My god, the tip is so thin. I love doing my liner with this. We're not gonna do a winged liner because in the picture she hasn't done any. So just gonna line my lash line and also put some mascara, prepare it for the fake lashes that I'm gonna go on with. In my waterline, I'm also putting some black kajal. And that is all done. Now coming back to the face, I'm gonna go in with my bronzer from the palette Focallure Makeup in the number 03. And this is a really handy palette, honestly. So just really warming up my skin with this brown shade. From the same palette, I'm taking my pink blush on and I'm putting that on the apples of my cheek. And again, I'm taking the highlight from that palette itself and I'm gonna highlight my face with that. I was tagged just in the eye look, so I'm gonna just go with my instinct and I would go for a nude lip when the eyes are really dramatic. So go in with your favorite nude shade. This is by Sleek Cosmetics and this is in the shade Birthday Suit. And with that, this look is complete.